Hello, welcome to the clinic. So today we're going to be fusing some clinical skills with some ASMR. We're going to be taking some eye and head measurements using the equipment set out here. We have our beautiful volunteer, so let's get started first with the cover test. So we're going to be covering the left eye, looking at the right eye for any movements of the eye coming back to the primary position. Let me cover the left, sorry, cover the right, looking at the left eye. Any movement? Excellent. Then we just do a swinging cover test, looking at the eye that's been under the cover for any movements, whether that's from out, in, top, oh, bottom there. And the pupil measuring gauge is pretty much self-explanatory. Ask the patient to look into the distance. Take a measurement of the pupil sizes there, moving along the scale. Probably about a 5 there in the right, and about a 5 in the left there. Marvellous. Let's move on to some pupil distance measurements. I'm going to do the monocular one using this scale here. Place that on the bridge of the nose. You want to keep it very steady. We're looking at this scale here, lining up with the centre of the pupil. And then we do the same on this side here. Use two hands if it helps. Patient must keep steady, looking off into the distance there. Excellent. I'm going to use the vertical part there just to measure the vertical aperture. That is the lower lid margin to the upper. Just like so. And any part of the scale there. That's about 9 millimeters. Wonderful. Total pupillary distance measurement now using the CT rule there. I'm going to ask the patient to look into my left eye, right eye, double check by going back to the left and looking into my right eye there. So use the scale from the outer iris in the right to the inner iris edge in the left there. Sometimes it's hard to find the centre of the pupil if the patient has a darker iris. So we use the edge of the iris to the inner iris there for the total pupillary distance. Okay, let's move on to some technical measurements. I'm going to use this here. In conjunction with the ruler here, I'm going to try head width. You want to be positioned like this, and this, and we're reading off the top scale there, the top scale here. That is head width. Just turn the cursor there. I'm going to be using this scale here. Place this there. Or if this doesn't come quite long enough to the patient's temple, go back this way. There we go. In fact, I'm going to go this way. With the temple there, ruler here, read off the scale, and that is your temple width. Okay, let's use this scale here. Very simple measurement this. This is the apical radius. I like to start big, looking for a snug fit at the bridge of the nose. So 8 is not too bad. A little bit of sideways movement there. Let's try the 7. Okay, just move it gently. You don't want to dig into the patient's bridge with the corners. 6 is not quite fitting snugly. 7 looks good. 8, a little bit loose. I'm going to go with an apical radius of 7 millimeters there. Okay, let's turn and use the scale here for the front angle. The cursors here, the largest, will align with the centre of the nose. Steady, we'll bring the cursor down until we have contact, and we'll take the measurement off the scale there. Easy to do the other one, just move the cursor, slide contact, and read off the scale there. Excellent. For the splay angle, I'm going to continue with this here. To place this line in the centre of the nose again, just there. You don't want this part to poke the patient in the eye, so just be aware that you're missing the eye there. The contact is here, and we read off the scale there. And for the opposing side, missing the eyeball there. Patient can close their eyes if they wish. Contact is made. And we read off the scale. Just there. Marvellous. Okay, I've set up the measuring device like so. Okay, I'm going to use this side here, like this. We're going to do distance between rims at 10 millimetres, bring that out there. I want to place this like so. Contact there and there. We're going to bring this little slider in, like this, until we have contact here. There we go, not too tight. And then you can take your measurement on the scale here. Flip it over, and we have 15 millimetres below crest. Okay, so contact is there. Bring the slider in there. Okay, so we have contact here, here, and just resting there. And we can take the measurement off the scale there. Very low measurement. Lovely. Okay, now I'm going to use the measuring device to check the crest height, and we'll be sure to add 5 millimeters onto the reading. We're going to use this little scale here. So we're going to hold like so. Good. And we're just going to use this scale here, and we're going to measure down to the lower lid the scale here, which that's approximately 8 millimeters there. We'll add 5 to that for the total crest height. Flip around, you'll see you have the scale there. You want the scale just off or through the pupil center, nice and steady, and we have a reading of 10 millimeters there, plus 5, crest height 15 millimeters. So a little bit of disparity there. Okay, just bringing you down a little bit there, ma'am. We're going to use the scale in this particular way to check the bridge projection using the scale here. So Ideally, we like the patient to look down. We place this part here with the line running through the centre of the nose again. And you want to gently slide the cursor in there. I'll bring it down for you so you can see better. Until this part just touches the patient's eyelashes. As the patient's looking down, you can ask them to blink so you know that there's contact with the edge of the slider there. So patient looking down, bring it in till you're close to the lashes. Patient blinks. When we just touch the lashes, we can take the reading off the scale there. Marvellous. Right, now we're going to try length to bend and angle of sight. I have the scale here. We just want it like so. So top of the ear. And this part just above the patient's eye. Bring the cursor in, so it's like that, against the eye, as you can see. Take the angular measurement there, and length to bend shall be from the top of the ear there. Marvellous. Okay, let's try length to tangent. And to place the ruler here. This will go behind the ear. And we'll take the measurement on the scale here to the front. Okay, now we're going to do the downward angle of drop. We're going to use the scale here and the cursor. So usually you'd have to bring the ear forward and this will touch in the space between the mastoid and the inner part of the ear from behind. Let me place that there. And we bring this cursor behind the ear there, very gently. We flip around, take the angular measurement on the scale there, and we repeat on the other side.